morning. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to bring up the father of our group, Mr. John Levy.
Was this a great, great day? And a wonderful day. You know, there's perfect weather, and I can finally say that W word. We've been wondering and watching, and nobody can talk about the weather, but boy, did it come through. Just a beautiful day for a beautiful wedding. And what a beautiful bride. We're so glad you wore that dress instead of your other choice, a U.S. women's soccer jersey. That's what you wanted to wear. But we all want to, Jen and I want to thank you all for being here. Special events are so much more special. We'll share them with good friends and family. And all of you here just made this evening so much more special for all of us. You know, over the years that I've known Vicki, she's done so much to endear herself. Over the years, I've been so impressed. The first time she came to our house to watch a football game, Matt and his friends, she really impressed me because she knew who Priest Holmes was. She knew who Priest Holmes was, a great running back from Beloved Chiefs, and she knew he went to Texas. Even though Vicki said that night, Priest Holmes should have gone to Notre Dame. You know, then Vicki did something that very few people have ever done. She gave away her ticket to the Masters. She gave me her ticket to the Masters, the toughest ticket in sports. And for that, I'll always be eternally grateful. Now finally, Vicki did something very special. She told me the colors tonight were going to be Royals blue. But then I realized she meant royal blue, so never mind. You know,
Sorry, which page?
But Vicki is one of the strongest, most capable, and smartest people I know. How else could somebody work full-time in a very stressful job, go to law school at a very prestigious law school, and plan a wedding? What Vicki has done is truly remarkable. We, Jen and I, are so pleased to welcome you into our family. We're very excited to have you with us. When I attended Andrew's bachelor party weekend in Yale, you invited me and I went.
Woo! Yeah. Chug.
Yeah, that didn't work out too well. I tried to chug a beer. It's been 3 years. But on Saturday night, they had planned a roast. They planned a roast of Andrew. The problem is that Andrew is unroastable. Nobody can say a bad word about Andrew. He is just such a wonderful person that all everybody said was what a good friend he was and how great he was. The only thing people said that was bad, that he did, had one bad habit. He has one seat on a couch that isn't alone, and nobody can sit in that seat. Now, anybody who's ever been to our house, you understand where he got that from. They can't even make fun of his golf game because it's too good. But I said at Andrew's bachelor party that a man's true worth is not money or possessions. It's in the friends and the love that he has. And when we look around this room and we see how many good friends Andrew has and how much this room is full of love and Vicki, I truly believe at a very young age, Andrew is one of the richest people I've ever met. Now finally, as a proud parent, I'm allowed to give a little advice. Having been married myself for over 36 years, thank you, my wife, for her infinite patience. But as I was thinking of what kind of toast, what kind of advice I could give, I thought about my friend Bill, who climbed Mount Kilimanjaro last February against Brian's best advice. But when I asked Bill how he could possibly climb Mount Kilimanjaro, first of all, I said it was a lot safer than his other choice, which was a pub crawl in Dublin. He went with two of his friends from college, from Notre Dame, and what amazed me was that Notre Dame alone would give up a pub crawl to Dublin. But they did, and they went on this 19,000 feet in sub-freezing temperatures to to the top of Mount Kilimanjaro and asked him, how did you do that at our advanced age? And he said, one step at a time. And if I have any advice to give Andrew and Vicky in their marriage, in this journey they're going to take together, take it one step at a time, one day at a time, one moment at a time. Cherish each other, love each other, listen to each other, and be there for each of you one day, one moment, one step at a time. And if you do that, you'll never reach the summit, but you'll just have a wonderful, wonderful journey. To Andrew and Vicky, may they have a journey of a lifetime. Thank you.
There we go, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together here for the father of our groom. Now, I think we want to know a little bit later, will you chug one here for us? Before we open, put the token of the dance floor. Ladies and gentlemen, please grab a silverware in front of you, start tapping on those plates and glass. We got to get a little pitch from our newlyweds. Ladies and gentlemen, your first four should be coming out in just a few moments, everyone.